हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द नेक्स्ट सेशन ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग मैकेनिक्स। दिस इज प्रोफेसर विद्या सर मोगी। इन दिस सेशन विल बी टेकिंग प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन एनालिसिस ऑफ कोप्लेनर नॉन कंकरेंट फोर्स सिस्टम। सो टू बिगिन विथ, द प्रॉब्लम स्टेटमेंट सेज अ रिजिड प्लेट ABCD इज सब्जेक्टेड टू अ फोर्स एज शोन। कंप्यूट द मैग्नीट्यूड, डायरेक्शन एंड लाइन ऑफ एक्शन ऑफ द रिजल्टेंट ऑफ अ सिस्टम with respect to the point A, which means you have to find out the resultant magnitude of the resultant, direction of the resultant and position of the resultant with respect to point A. Now you can see the force system where there are object is subjected to number of forces. The size of the lamina is 1 meter by 1 meter. So before we start, firstly, you have to resolve the force, whichever are to be resolved. Now, 100 kN is acting in horizontal direction, so it has no effect in Y. So, no problem with this. But this 200 kN is making an angle of 30 degrees. So, this should be resolved first. So, when you resolve this, this is the vertical component of force. This is the horizontal component of force. So horizontal component will be 200 cos 30 and this will be what? 200 sin 30. Now coming to this force, 100 kN is making downwards. It has no effect in X, so leave this. But whereas this 200 is again inclined with respect to 45 degrees. So resolve this force into horizontal component and vertical component. Then the vertical component will be acting downwards and it is 200 sin 45 and this horizontal component is 200 cos 45, which is acting leftwards. Now that we have resolved all the forces, let's start with finding the forces in X direction, or grouping the force acting in X direction and Y direction. So grouping all the force acting in X direction is summation Fx. So what are the forces in X direction? 1, 2, 3. We have three forces. So first force is minus 200 cos 45. This is acting leftward. So minus 200 cos 45. This force is acting rightward. So plus 100. This force is also acting rightward. So plus 200 cos 30. So solving this, you will get 131 plus 0.78 kN. So direction is positive, so I will indicate with the arrow mark rightwards. Now finding what is for sum of all the forces in Y direction. So how many forces in Y direction? Starting with this, acting downwards, so minus 200 sin 45. Minus 100 is also acting, 100 is acting downwards, so minus 100. This force is acting upwards, so plus 200 sin 30. So altogether, this force will be minus 141.42 kN. So this force is acting downward. So resultant of force is acting downward. Then, once we have found out summation Fx and summation Fy, find out what is resultant. So resultant is what? Under the root, sum of all the force in X direction plus sum of all the force in Y direction. So get what is value of R. So value of R is 193.3 kN. Now that you have found resultant, magnitude of resultant, find what is the direction of resultant. Tan inverse of summation Fy by summation Fx. So this will be 47.02. So up till here it is almost similar to problems on coplanar concurrent force. From here onwards it changes. So now to find the position of resultant, which is the additional part which is required in this particular problem. Position of resultant is found with respect to what? He has told with respect to what? Taking reference as point A. So to find the position of resultant is nothing but the distance of the resultant. So to find the position, what I require? First I require moment about point A. So to find moment about point A, what about this 100 kN? So 100 is acting about point A, means line of action of 100 is also same as that of point A, so no perpendicular distance, so this force is 0. What about 200 sine 45? 200 sine 45 is also in line about point A, so this force is also equal to 0. So 100 is 0, 200 sine 45 is also 0. Let's check for any other force which will become 0. Check this force, 200 cos 30, this is also in line with A, so this force also is 0. So 1, 2 and 3, 3 forces are 0. Now to start with 200 cos 45. About point A, how will this 200 cos 45 rotate? This 200 cos 45 will rotate like this. So about point A, this will rotate like this. So what is the direction of rotation? It is anti-clockwise. So minus 200 cos 45 into, what is the perpendicular distance? 200 cos 45 is rotating anti-clockwise. So what is the perpendicular distance? Perpendicular distance is 1. So into 1. What about this 100? So about point A, how is 100 rotating? About point A, 100 is rotating like this. It is rotating like this. So it is clockwise. So plus 100 into, what is the perpendicular distance? 100, perpendicular distance is 1. So perpendicular distance is 1. Then, what about this 200 sine 30? About point A, how is 200 sine 30 rotating? It is rotating like this. It is rotating like this. So this is what? Anticlockwise. So anticlockwise means what? Minus 200 sine 30 into, what is the perpendicular distance? Perpendicular distance is 1 meter. Then moment about A is what? Solving this, you will get moment as 141.42 kilonewton meter. Now we know what are the equations to find out the distance. So D is given by modulus of moment about A divided by R. So moment about A is what? Minus 141.42 divided by resultant is 193.3. Means you will get this value as 0.731 meter. And what is x-intercept? Means the resultant will cut at what distance on x-axis. So that is given by moment at A divided by summation Fy. So this is minus 141.42 divided by minus 141.42. The value of Fy is also 141.42. Then you get this as 1 meter. Then value of y, that is modulus of A divided by summation fx. So value of m is minus 141.42 divided by value of fx is 131.78. So you get this as 1.07 meter. So that, now that we have got value of d, x and y, we need to locate the value of these three on the element. Now this is a rectangular element which is of size 1 meter by 1 meter. So this is about point A. So about point A, from point A, what is the distance of the resultant? So how, what is the direction of resultant? So to determine the direction of resultant, we should check with this. Fx is rightwards, positive, and Fy is downwards. So how is the direction of resultant? Direction of resultant is like this, means resultant is acting downwards. At what distance the resultant is acting? So resultant is acting at distance of 0.731, means check with x value. So this is x axis, this is y axis. What is the distance at which the resultant is acting? X is resultant is acting at a distance of 1 meter from x. In x direction, A is here, from here in horizontal direction, and resultant is at this point. Where is the resultant at y-axis? So from point A, in y-direction, resultant is at, this is 1 meter, 0.07. So resultant is somewhere here. Then you have to draw this line like this. So this is how the resultant cuts. And this value indicates, which is perpendicular. So this value is D, which is 0.731. This is X value, which is 1 meter. And this is Y value, which is 1.07 meter. So this is the angle made by the resultant, which is 47.02 alpha equal to. So this is how you have to approach the problems on analysis of coplanar non-concurrent force system. So moving on to the next problem. So the next problem reads, a bracket is subjected to a five forces and a couple as shown. Determine magnitude, direction and line of action of the resultant about point A. So again you have to look at about point A. So to begin with, see the forces, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 forces and one couple. So here you have to resolve this force. This force is 6 kN, which is making an angle of 30 degrees. So horizontal component of force is this, and direction of the angle, direction of the force is this side. And this is the vertical component of force, and this is direction, leftward, downward. So this is 6 cos 30. This is 6 sin 30. Similarly, we have one more force here. Horizontal force will be rightwards, vertical force will be downwards. So this will be 8 cos 45. This is 8 sin 45. Now that we have resolved all the forces, let's begin with finding the or grouping the forces in x direction and y direction. So first we'll start grouping the forces in x direction. So how many forces in x direction? So 1, 2 and 3. So this force is acting rightwards, so plus 6. This force is acting leftwards, so minus 6 cos 30. And this force is acting rightwards, so plus 8 cos 45. So solving this with the sign, you'll get this as 6.46 kN. Group all the forces acting in y direction, so summation Fy, one force plus 5 because acting upwards, this 5 acting downwards, so minus 5, then this force acting downwards minus 6 sin 30, this force acting downwards minus 8 sin 45. So these are the forces, so answer will be minus 8.65 kN. Now that we have grouped forces in x and y, we will find out what is the value of resultant. So resultant is given by sum of all the forces in x direction, sum of all the forces in y direction. So solving this, you will get the value of resultant as 10.63 kN. Then find out the direction of resultant, which is alpha equal to tan inverse of summation Fy by summation Fx, which is equal to 53.24 degrees. Then we'll quickly find out what is the direction of resultant. So Fx is positive, is acting rightwards, Fy is negative, so it is acting downwards. So based on this, we'll decide the direction of resultant. Fx is this, Fy is this, then resultant is acting like this. This is the angle made by the resultant. Now they have told about point A, then we will find out position of resultant by finding the moment about point A. So taking moment about point A, firstly we will find out what are the forces that are causing zero moment. Which are the forces that will be zero? What about this 5? It is in line with point A, so this 5 is ruled out. So this is zero. What about this? It will rotate. What about this? This will rotate. What about this? This will rotate. What about this 6 cos 30? This is in line with point A, so this is again 0. These two forces are considered. Now starting with first force. How is 5 kN rotating about point A? 5 kN is rotating like this. So this is clockwise rotation. So with what distance it is rotating? It is rotating with a distance of 15 cm. So 5 is force, perpendicular distance is 15. So plus 5 into 15. How is 6 kN rotating about point A? 6 is rotating like this. It will rotate like this. 6 will rotate like this, again clockwise. So plus 6 into what is the perpendicular distance of the force about point A. Force is this, perpendicular distance is 10 centimeter. So 6 into 10. What about this force? This is not a force, this is a moment. So already this is a moment, means it is already converted to moment. That is, perpendicular distance is already multiplied. So that is also rotating clockwise. So it is plus 10. What about 6 sine 30 about point A? So this will also rotate clockwise. This will also rotate clockwise. So plus 6 sine 30. And what is the perpendicular distance of 6 sine 30 about point A? So from here to here, 15, 15, 15. So it is 45. So into 45. What about this force now? About point A, how will this rotate? It will rotate like this. It will rotate like this. So means it is rotating anti-clockwise. So this is minus 8 cos 45. Minus 8 cos 45 into what is the perpendicular distance? So this distance is 10 centimeter. So force, perpendicular distance is 10. So 8 sin 45 into 10. How is this 8 sin 45 rotating about point A? So this will rotate like this. It will rotate like this. So this is clockwise. So plus 8 sin 45 into what is the perpendicular distance? Force is here, A is here. Perpendicular distance is this, 15, 15, 15. So 8 sin 45 into 15. Solving together, all together, you get moment about A as 477.98, which is rounded off to 478 kilonewton centimeter. This is the force. Now find out what is distance D, what is distance X, and what is distance Y. So distance D, after solving, I'll get this as 44.96 centimeters, X as 55.26 centimeters, and Y as 73.99 centimeters. So assignment for you people is, you have to plot the position of resultant with respect to these values. Hope you follow this. So this is all for the session. I'll be taking up some more examples related to the concept in the next session. Thank you. Thank you very much.